topic is logical implication. So before going to the logical implication, see here the proposition P, 10 is a multiple of 2. And consider another proposition Q, 4 is a square number. So condition of the statement P implies Q is, if 10 is a multiple of 2, then 4 is a square number. Here the statement P is true. 4 is a square number. The statement Q is also true. Means the proposition P and Q are true. If P implies Q, if both the P and Q are true, then the P implies Q is also true. Here the P implies Q is true. But is there any consistency or any senses between these two sentences? Is they are interrelated? No, there is no sense or any consistency in between the statements, because there is no consistency. So that's why that not make any sense here. So consider the same as another one example, like a P. 4 is a odd number. Consider another statement Q. 3 plus 7 equal to 9. 4 is odd number. Statement is false. 3 plus 7 equal to 9. Statement is false. Now consider the conditional P implies Q. If 4 is an odd number, then 3 plus 7 equal to 9. Again see here, is there any consistency or is there any sense in the P implies Q? No, there is no sense in between the sentences or any sentence, whatever the condition that we have written here, there is no sense in the statement here. So that's why there is no consistency in the statement P implies Q. See here, the P is true, P is false, Q is false, then P implies Q is true. But there is no sense in the sentence. Hence, we say that the conditional for which the truth value of Q is depends on truth value of P. Truth value of Q depends on the truth value of P, or vice versa, truth value of P is depends on truth value of Q. So those are called hypothetical statements. Those are called hypothetical statements or implicative statements. That means, suppose the P implies Q is your conditional, in which the truth value of Q must be depends on the truth value of P. That kind of the statements are called hypothetical statements or implicative statements. So in the hypothetical or implicative statements, for the conditional, truth value of Q must be depends on truth value of P, or vice versa. So now see, consider a hypothetical statement P implies Q is such that Q is true whenever P is true. Then we say that, P implies Q, and we write it in symbolically, P implies Q. This symbol is used for the implies, that is called the logical implication. Means if Q is true whenever P is true. So then we say that the P implies Q. So for example, suppose you have a truth table like this. Suppose you assume the possible truth values. So Q is true whenever P is true. Here the Q is true, P is also true. Then we say that the P implies Q. So that is called the logical implication. So first we have seen that what is the hypothetical statement. Hypothetical statements means truth value of Q must be depends on the truth value of P or vice versa. So next, suppose if P implies Q is a hypothetical statement, then Q is true whenever P is true. Then we say that the P implies Q. So see here, the Q is true whenever P is true. Then we say that the P implies Q. Now see the necessary and sufficient conditions. Now see the what is necessary condition and what is the sufficient conditions. Suppose P and Q are the two propositions and whose truth values are dependent on each other. Suppose the P implies Q is there. Suppose the P implies Q is there, then Q may be true. Q may be true. But Q may be true. But it is sufficient that it is sufficient that P is true. Q may be true, but it is sufficient that the P is true. That is the necessary condition. But we don't know exactly what may be. The Q may be true, but it is sufficient that the P is true. And similarly, necessary condition states that P is true, then it is necessary that Q is true. Sufficient condition states that P is true. Sufficient states that Q may be true. It is sufficient that the Q is true. Necessary says that P is true, then it is necessary that the Q must be a true. Those are the conditions for necessary and sufficient. Sufficient condition says that the Q may be true. It is necessary. It is sufficient that the P is true. Necessary condition states that P is true, then it is necessary that the Q is true. In a view of the interpretation, all of the above statements will be taken carry the meaning P implies Q. P is sufficient for Q. Q is necessary for Q is necessary for P. Those are the necessary and sufficient condition. For the two propositions P and Q, also the following propositions are possible. See here, necessary and sufficient conditions. Suppose the P and Q are the two propositions. P implies Q is true. Means suppose there is a P implies Q, then Q is maybe true, but it is sufficient that the Q is true. And second one, and also P is true, then it is necessary that Q is also true. We rated it in the meaning P implies Q. P is sufficient for Q. Q is necessary for the P. Now see here, for any two propositions, P and Q, the following statements taken carry the So, following conditions are be necessary. So, these situations may be came. So, in that the first one is P implies Q, but Q not implies P. P implies Q, but Q not implies P. In this case, P is sufficient. P is sufficient. P is sufficient but not a necessary condition, but not a necessary condition for Q. And second possibility is P is not implies Q, but Q implies P. In this case, P is necessary for Q. In this case, P is necessary for Q. Consider the third one. See here, in this case, P is necessary condition for Q. In the third one, P implies Q and Q implies P. In this case, P is a necessary and sufficient condition. P is a necessary and sufficient condition for Q. So see here, P implies Q, Q is not implies P. In this case, P is a sufficient but not a necessary. P is not implies Q, but the Q implies P. Here the P is a necessary for the Q but not a sufficient condition. In the third case, P implies Q, Q implies P. P is a necessary and sufficient condition for the Q and vice versa. Q is a necessary and sufficient condition for the Q. So here the vice versa. P is necessary and sufficient condition for the Q, and Q is a necessary and sufficient condition for the P. This is will also be written as P if and only if, which can also be written as P if F Q. P if and only if can also be written like this. So necessary and sufficient condition is like this. So Q may be a true, sufficient that the Q is true. P is true, then it is necessary that the Q is true. So based on the situations which are possible, P implies Q, Q is not implies P. In this case, P is a sufficient. P implies Q, but the Q is, P is not implies Q, but the Q implies P. So P is a necessary for the Q. Suppose P implies Q, Q implies P. Then P is a necessary and sufficient condition for the Q. And Q is a necessary and sufficient condition for the P. So that can be written as P if and only if. P if and only if Q. That can also be written as like this, P, I, F, F, Q. That is nothing but the P if and only if Q. Consider the example here. Consider proposition P, the integer X is even. Q, the integer X is divisible by 2. The integer X is divisible by 2. Here the P implies Q, because Q is true only when P is true, and P is true only when Q is true. That also implies Q implies P. P implies Q, Q implies P. See here, the P is depends on Q, Q depends on P. And our implication says that the P is true whenever the Q is true. Q is true whenever the P is true. So they are interrelated and make the sense, and the P implies Q and the Q implies P. That is, P if and only if q. So now I'm going with an example. Prove the following. Prove the following. So first one is P and P implies Q. Implies Q. So first I am going to construct the truth tables. Possible truth values are now construct P implies Q. P implies Q. 0 implies 0, 1. 0 implies 1, 1. 1 implies 0, 0. 1 implies 1, 1. Now P implies Q. 0 and 1. 0 and 1. 1 and 0. 1 and 1. Now come to the P and P implies Q. Implies the Q. Q is true whenever this one will be true. See here. Q is here. Q is true whenever this one is true. Therefore, P and P implies Q is true. P and P implies Q is true. Then Q is also true. Then Q is true. Therefore, P and P implies Q implies a Q. Clear it is? So first we constructed a tables and then we constructed a P implies Q. So after that P and P implies Q. See here, the P and P implies Q is true. Then Q is also true. Therefore P and P implies Q is implies a Q.